This is maybe the greatest mystery ever since Kerbal Space Program version 0.22, the Mystery Goo trademark containment unit. Its fascinating science reports like and have kept everyone intrigued as to what this goo could be made of and what its properties are. To get more insight into the properties of the Mystery Goo, I will attempt to determine the density of the goo. We know that the whole container with the goo has a mass of 0.05 tons, or 50 kilograms. If we can determine the mass of the unit without the goo and subtract that from that 50 kilograms, we will know the mass of the goo itself. And then if we know the volume of the goo, we can calculate the density. To do that, I attached a container to a 1.25 meter part for comparison. That way we can measure out its exact dimensions. I assumed that the container is made out of aluminium, a light but durable material. So, after some measuring, I got all kinds of dimensions of all the segments of the container. These bits have the volume of half a sphere. These are just cylindrical parts, and these are made out of hollow cylinders. The volumes of these shapes are well known, and thus we can use these expressions immediately. My question to you is, should we assume these caps to be hollow? Or should we assume they contain some kind of electronics or anything like that, or something in between? In the case of non-hollow caps, the mass of the container without the goo is 45.5 kilograms. In the case of hollow caps, we get a mass of 34.1 kilograms. Subtract these from the total mass of the container and we obtain the mass of the goo. Now, if we measure the volume that the goo takes up right here, we can calculate the density. And this results in a density of 573 kilograms per cubic meter for the non-hollow caps and 2,832 kilograms per cubic meter for the hollow caps. And to be fair, due to the fact that we do not know what is inside of these bastardly segments, the only thing we can say about the goo is that it has a density between these values. So, it could be anything based on this information, sadly. And this does not rule out the theory. This is all fun and games, but there is something more interesting going on with the Mystery Goo. A big spoiler warning to those who have not read all the science reports regarding the Mystery Goo. So you have been warned. This section basically lays out a summary by a user called Mantha on the Steam community page. Be sure to check it out after this video. Again, do not proceed if you do not want to know the deeper mysteries regarding the science reports. I tried to get these reports in the game, but I couldn't recreate them. So I delved into the game files as Mantha suggested, and here is what I found. It all starts when you read the science reports about the goo on Kerbin. For example, when in the desert it says, the goo seems to hate it here. And when splashed down, it seems to escape into the water. So it seems to be attracted to water for some reason, and it does not like the hot and dry desert. Moving on, we arrive in space around Kerbin, and the goo becomes brittle. And near Moho, a report states that the goo is almost boiling and that it writhes around in the canister. This is another confirmation that the goo has some aversion to heat or intense sunlight. And in other places in space, it does seem to feel right at home, strangely enough. And when orbiting planets like Eve and Duna, the goo seems to take on a different color, matching the planet in question. So what thing can change color so suddenly according to its environment? While we move farther out in the Kerbal system, we discover even weirder things. When in space around Bob, the whole canister begins to resonate with the entire spacecraft, making the crew aboard very uncomfortable. Entering the vicinity of Pol, the goo seems to reach out of the canister, before it freezes and the tentacle that it formed breaks off. So what is happening, and is there something else in the container? And finally, when we arrive at Ilu, while the Kerbals observe the goo, they feel as though something is looking back at them, from the shadows of the container. Is the Mystery Goo actually alive? Well, there's actually something else we can do. If you look at the Mystery Goo container in the game, take a screenshot and then turn up the exposure on the image, you will see that these holes are not completely black. So there is something in there. We can go back into the game files again and take a look at the textures of the Mystery Goo. Open them in Photoshop and turn up the exposure and brightness again. And what you will see will shock you. Can you see it? Looking back at you, staring directly at you.